So SideQuest just launched a mobile app for your phone. This means you can sideload any VR game that's on their platform very easily without the need for a bulky PC.
SideQuest, you know that popular app that has a ton of free games not available on the official Quest store? Games like the Doom 3 Quest port, Pokemon VR and many others. So this mobile app is pretty exciting as now everyone can sideload these games. It is a lot easier
and you can even do it on the road if you want to. Hey everyone, Cass here, and I have been waiting for this for so long, so in this video I'll show you exactly how to do it. By the way, before you could also sideload with the app called Bugjaeger as well, which I covered too. However, that doesn't work with SideQuest games since you cannot download the APK files from SideQuest, so you would still miss out on many games, and now you don't have to. So let's get started. But first, if you like to see more VR tech tips like this one, subscribe if you haven't yet. It's a big support. And now join me beyond reality. So this is actually really easy to do, easier than the previous method with Bugjaeger even. I think the SideQuest team did an amazing job here, but let me first tell you what you're going to need. First thing you need is an Android phone. It doesn't work on iOS, unfortunately. Then you need your Quest 1 or your Quest 2. And then you also need a USB cable that can go in your phone, but also in your Quest. I'm using the USB-C to USB-C cable that was in the box with my Quest 2. So you still need to activate developer mode on your Quest first. If you haven't done that yet, then you can continue watching. If you have, then you can skip to step 2 with the timestamps below. But now, let's start this guide. Step 1, enable developer mode on your Quest. Of course, this also works on Quest 1. It's the same exact steps. And since we're doing something that doesn't need a PC, we're going to do all this on my phone. So to make things easier, you can use the same phone you use to install the Oculus app. So on your phone, open up your browser and go to
developer.oculus.com, manage organizations, create.
If you're not signed in yet, then make sure you sign in with the same Oculus or Facebook account you use with your Quest. You should then be redirected back to the page we tried to open before. If it didn't, just open the link again. All the links are in the description, by the way. Then create an organization here. This can be any name you want. Now, you may get the question to fill out your credit card or phone number to verify your Oculus account. This is an extra security added by Oculus, so you gotta do it, unfortunately, if you want to sideload. But you won't be asked about this if you already filled it out. This could be the case if you already bought a game before, for example. Once done, make sure to read and agree to the developer agreement. Now, if you open this sidebar at the bottom left, you should be able to see your new organization in this drop-down menu. This means you are now ready to enable developer mode on your Quest. So now open the Oculus app, which is the app you use to set up your Quest. Then go to the settings at the bottom right and click on your Oculus Quest 2 headset that you're using. And once you see that it's connected, you should be able to see the more settings show up. If it doesn't, just click on this arrow right here and click on more settings and click on developer mode. And then you can use this toggle right here to enable developer mode. If it turns blue, you're ready to go to the next step. Step 2, download the SideQuest app. You can now download the SideQuest app via the Google Play Store. Remember, this only works on Android since it uses ADB functions. So go to the Play Store and then search for SideQuest. Make sure to pick the right one with this logo, then click on install. Once installed, open it. And you might get a pop-up, just click allow here.
Step 3, connect a USB cable.
So get your USB cable, connect it to your phone on one side. Then get your Quest out and make sure that it is turned on. And then put the other side of the cable inside your Quest. All like this. I've got another cable here because I got the Elite battery strap. Okay, both are connected now. And now on your phone, you might get the pop-up, allow SideQuest installer to access Quest 2. You can mark the checkbox, always open SideQuest installer when Quest 2 is connected here. Then click OK. The same goes for the next pop-up. You may also get the message first to choose an app for USB devices. Then just make sure to select SideQuest installer, and then you can also click always, so your phone remembers your choice and you don't get these pop-up each time. Okay, before it works, you will also need to allow USB debugging and access tries inside your Quest. So I'm going to put it on, getting my controller here. Okay, allow USB debugging. I click allow. Here you can also use the checkbox always allow so that you don't get this pop-up again. And then again, you have to click allow. Allow access to data, also allow. And then in the app again, the SideQuest logo should turn green. This means the Quest is connected and you're ready to get sideloading. Step 4, sideloading an app via USB or wireless. Now you can already sideload apps just by clicking on an app and then tapping install to headset. However, there are some pros and cons here. Using the cable is easy, but it does drain your phone's battery pretty fast, and it's not faster in any way than doing it wirelessly, so I highly recommend doing this wireless method that I will explain in the next step. Step 5, sideloading wirelessly. So to connect your phone wirelessly, make sure your cable is still connected to your Quest and also your phone. Then in the SideQuest app, make sure that the icon is still green, and then click on the wireless icon at the left. Here you can click on enable Wi-Fi. You might get a couple of pop-ups again, just click allow and okay, you know the drill. Now unplug your cable. Don't worry if this icon turns red now, Wi-Fi should still be enabled anyways. To connect wirelessly now, you just go back to the Wi-Fi menu and over here, type in your headset's local IP address. This is mine, and then just click on connect. Keep in mind that this IP address is not your public IP address, but your local one. And if it doesn't show up here in the app, then you can also find this address in your Quest under the Wi-Fi icon, and then click on the network you're connected to, scroll down to advanced, and you should be able to see your local IP address there. Usually a local IP address starts with 192, but it could be something else as well. So once you've clicked on connect, the icon down here should now be green, even without the cable. So now you can sideload apps wirelessly, and you can even keep your phone charged if you need it. That's it, you can now sideload anything that's on SideQuest, even without the PC. And I think that's pretty awesome because it makes it so much easier. Plus, no one is left out anymore.
Now to find your sideloaded game on your Quest, put on your headset, go to apps, then from the drop-down menu at the top right, select unknown sources, and that's where you can find all your sideloaded stuff.
So even for games in App Lab, it's easier with this app because you can find all App Lab links through SideQuest, and then you can install it from there, and it will automatically launch the Oculus app actually if you have that installed on the same device. It's nice. You can also easily enable the graphics settings in the app by clicking on the three dots at the bottom and then going to tools. And if you have your Quest connected, you can try all these commands and have fun with them. Remember, this does cause performance issues, so if that happens, just restart your Oculus Quest headset and the settings should all go back to default. So before we move to the outro, I wanted to give you some extra tips and tricks in case you have some trouble. At the time of making this video, the developer has told me that sideloading via USB or Wi-Fi is still pretty slow, but they are looking into speeding things up, so we just have to be a little patient for now until then. If enable Wi-Fi did not work for you, sometimes you need to keep your Quest screen on when you tap that button. So what you can do is put your finger on that sensor so it stays on while you try the steps again.
If it still doesn't work on your phone, it could be that your phone does not support USB on the go. You can check your phone specs for this, but most newer phones should have support. If your phone does not support USB OTG, then you can only enable Wi-Fi via the PC or use the USB cable to sideload. If connecting to Wi-Fi doesn't work, double check whether you have allowed all pop-ups in your Quest headset and make sure you have selected Always Allow.
If it still doesn't work, try disabling developer mode on your phone if you have that on. If you tried the previous Bugjaeger method, for example, then you probably have it on still. With SideQuest, you do not need this on. In fact, it could mess things up. So to turn it off on your phone, go to your phone settings, scroll down all the way to developer options. If you see it there, you can turn it off with the toggle. If it's not there, then it's off already and you're good to go. So those are some of my last last tips. Let me know if it works for you and what you think about the SideQuest app on mobile. Are you going to use it now? Let me know in the comments below. And if you have some time left, you can support us for free by watching more videos. I got a lot more VR tech tips for you for every headset owner. And you can check out this playlist right here, I think, if you want to see more. And maybe you'll learn a little bit more and support us for free as well. And a special thanks go to all our champions, especially these patrons down below. And as always, VR on!